We're in a very exciting time in dentistry that's being driven by two very powerful trends. When you take science and you collide it with a very powerful demographic trend, you get something that creates a whole different aspect in the industry. Let me give you an example. When we went through the cosmetic boom in dentistry, it was fueled by two things. One, we had the technology to create beautiful teeth, in some cases even more beautiful than what people originally came with. But what really fueled the whole trend wasn't necessarily just the science, but the demographics behind it. Cosmetic dentistry came into its own at the exact same time that the baby boomers, one of the largest generations we've ever had in America, 80 million people, entered into the highest income earning period of their lives, 45 to 55. They wanted to look good, they wanted to feel good, and so spending their money on cosmetic dentistry was a natural. So you had the science that enabled us to deliver what they wanted, and you had a very large market that wanted it. When those two things collided, we had a huge trend in dentistry. Well, fast forward now. We're in a whole different demographic time. The baby boomers now are turning 65 at a rate of 10,000 people a day. And when you think about the mentality of a 65-year-old is very different than the mentality of a 45-year-old. When you're 45, you're thinking about taking over the world, looking good, everything's wonderful. By the time you get to 65, you're just thinking about holding on to your money, holding on to your health, holding on to everything that you have. So the whole health and wellness is heavy on people's minds today of that generation. So now you look at the science. We've had the science around for decades. We know that what goes on in the mouth affects what's going on in your whole body. We've known that for a long time. But it's only now that it's starting to come to the forefront because we have a generation, we have a market that's paying attention to it and wants to know. So the good news is the science exists. We've got a market that wants it. So a properly positioned practice will be able to take advantage of a huge trend that will take dentistry on to a whole other generation. Now, here's the catch. One of the things we know is that people buy what they're interested in, not what you're interested in. And so one of the real keys is when you sit down with your patients is not to be so excited about what you have to tell them first as much as what it is that they're interested in. What is it that's on their mind? What's their biggest concern? What is it that weighs most heavily on them? Find out first what they want. And then show them how you can help them get what they want. For example, let's go back to cosmetic dentistry. People don't really want white teeth. They really don't want veneers. They really don't want all of the procedures that we're able to perform as much as they want what those procedures will do for them. They don't want the white teeth as much as they want the social acceptance and the feeling that people admire them and look up to them because of how they look. They don't necessarily want the veneers as much as they want the beautiful smile and the acceptance. Well, the same thing's true with health. We don't necessarily want the cleaning. We don't necessarily want the periodontal therapy. We don't want all of those things as much as we want the benefits that those things will give us. The better feeling, the feeling rested, feeling healthy, and what it'll enable us to do in life to engage in those kind of activities that we want to engage in. So here's my challenge to you, is with all the excitement that there is about the oral systemic link, before you go in and overwhelm your patients with all kinds of information and data and statistics and science, stop and ask yourself, do I really know what this patient wants and why they want it? Take a few minutes to get to know them. Find out what's on their mind. What's their primary interest? What are their biggest concerns? What do they want most in life? What are the things that they worry about? Because something in what they say will open up a door that will enable us to connect what they want with what we know that they need and what we can provide. That's my challenge to you. Ask, don't tell. Find out what your patients want and then show them how you can deliver it. Now go make it happen.